Let's go surfing now. Everybody's learning how. Come on a safari with me.
Robbie Gilmore's The Christian Car Guy Show. But this is not Robbie. This is his sidekick, Bill Mixon. I'm a regular on Robbie's show, and Robbie has earned a vacation with his family, and we pray it is a wonderful vacation. I've got the pleasure to be here with a good friend of mine, Diane Garrett, who knows Asheville a whole lot better than I do, and we're going to talk about day trips. I've gotten into the habit of going around the area and visiting our natural areas and our state parks and our wilderness areas and doing some hiking. And we're hoping that those of you in the audience will call in and share some of your favorite day trips, particularly those that you would encourage other people to go to. Our call-in number is 866-348-7884. 866-348-7884. Please call in and share one of your favorite day trips. I was going to start with Diane and let her tell us about one of her favorite trips in the Asheville area. Good morning.
Good morning, Bill. Asheville is a day trip, even though it's 2 hours from Winston, but it is well worth it to get up in the morning and drive to Asheville. It's a beautiful drive. Once you hit the mountains, and it's just gorgeous. But the day trip is not a specific place in Asheville. It is the city itself. It is so eclectic and unique, and it's just amazing. And from April until October, there is something going on all the time, and especially on weekends, music festivals, art festivals. Then there, my favorite day to go would be on Friday. And spend the day Friday and stay for the drum circle, where everyone drums at Pritchard Park downtown, and you can participate, you can dance, you can hula hoop. I actually hula hoop, and so I would hula hoop down there. But it is just amazing. The drum circle is fantastic, and there are wonderful ethnic local restaurants.
What's your favorite restaurant?
My favorite restaurant is... There's so many to pick from.
You better pick one.
Okay. I never had Korean food until I moved to Asheville. I lived in Asheville for 3.5 years. But there's a Korean restaurant, and I can't think of the name there right now. But it is fantastic. But then there is Mela, which is an Indian restaurant downtown, and I love Mela.
So, yeah, there's some restaurants in the state that I like to take a trip to and go see, and there's some up in the Blowing Rock area that are fun. One of the areas I really love to go hiking on is the backside of Grandfather Mountain. Now, there are a lot of people that have been up to the Swinging Bridge part of Grandfather Mountain, but I like to go in from the backside, which is off the Blue Ridge Parkway. Beautiful place to park, and there's a trail up there called Daniel Boone Trail, Daniel Boone Scout Trail. Now, it's a little steep going up, but you get to the top, it levels off some, and there's some of the most unbelievable vistas that in the entire state. There's a place called Watauga View that I usually like to hike up to. Now, I love to get up early enough so that I catch the sunrise. And if you look at my Facebook page, you'll see lots of sunrise pictures. But I can go up there and start off at sunrise and get a good 8-mile hike in and still make it to Blowing Rock and find a good restaurant to have a late lunch. Where else do you like to go?
Well, in Asheville, around Asheville, there are great hiking trails. I don't hike. I broke my ankle years ago.
Yeah, those you normally heal.
I have 22 screws and 2 steel rods in that my leg.
Well, maybe not.
No, so I'm not taking the chance. But the hiking trails my friends would go on went around falls, looking like amazing photos that they would share with me. But what I did do, not at sunrise, but I would go with my friends. We would put inner tubes on the French Broad River.
Oh, that's a wonderful place.
And float down the river, just float down 2 hours, cost nothing. We had our inner tubes, and then we climb out at this, it was sort of just a little dive restaurant that had open seating outside, and have a hamburger.
Well, you know, the Appalachian Trail runs right up through that area. And I don't know, I always had been a dream of mine to do some hiking on the Appalachian Trail. Have you had any friends that have done the Appalachian Trail?
No, I haven't. I haven't.
Have you heard about it? You know about it?
I know about the Appalachian Trail, in fact. my ex-husband, my son's father, his father lived in Bluefield, West Virginia, but had a farm in Bland. And the Appalachian Trail actually ran through it.
Right through. It goes from Georgia up through most of the North Carolina mountains, and then it comes out in Virginia.
Right.
And one of the places that I just really have discovered this year and love tremendously is to get up. There's a place called Scales. There's a set of trails. Griffin Park. And the Blue Ridge Parkway comes right through the ridge, and it's one of the highest points in the East Coast, the highest point in Virginia. But you can drive up this road. It's probably the roughest road I've ever taken my Jeep in. And you get to the top, and there's a great big parking area. It's fenced off, and they've got an outhouse. I mean, when I say outhouse, I mean outhouse, which is a whole lot better than no outhouse. But the Appalachian Trail comes through, and they've got wild ponies. And the last three times I went, they had longhorn steer wandering around free, loose on the park. And I understand there's some bears. I missed a mama bear and a baby bear by just a couple minutes. But it is a neat time to go up this time of year because it's a lot cooler than it is in Winston. I did a 9-mile hike a couple weeks ago. And the vistas, the to be on top of the mountains, and every direction you look, there's just wildlife. There's, there are hundreds of wild ponies up there running around free, and wild horses. It's a neat place to go. You can come in from the other side and park like a normal person would, and take the kids down and see the horses and the ponies. Might even see some of the longhorn steer. But on the backside, if you're a serious hiker, it's a way to get to the top of the mountain and to be able to put in some real mileage with just unbelievable views. Now, what else do you like to do in the Asheville area?
Well, I do want to say something about, now, I want to go on this day trip on the family side, the backside, where I don't have to climb anything, because I would love to see the ponies. But also in Asheville, there are bears, and there are bears that come up on your front porch. When I moved back to Winston in November, the moving truck was there. It was 8 o'clock at night, and they were still moving. And I was standing out in the front yard, and one of the movers said, "Oh, look, there goes a bear right across my front yard." And I'm thinking, "Oh my," I said, "I'm in the house." But again, Asheville, there are just so many places, local art galleries with –
Now, have you been to the one on the Blue Ridge Parkway? There's an art gallery on the parkway.
I have. The very first thing I did, I didn't know anyone when I moved to Asheville. I took my dogs, and we did a drive on the parkway. And I stopped there, and that was wonderful. But I love the ones in Asheville because I knew so many artists, people that had their art, their paintings in local galleries. And it was just fantastic. And again, the music festivals. I can't say enough about Asheville. Just, it is an adventure.
Now, have you been to the Blue Ridge Music Center up near Mount Airy?
No, I've never been there.
Oh, we took my wife's stepfather. We're looking after him, and we got him for a road trip. And we needed to find, we have him in a memory care unit. We're trying to find just the right distance. But from Winston, we can go up to Mount Airy, and we can get on the parkway. And there is an awesome place up there. If you love the old dulcimer music, if you love the banjo playing, if you love – I mean, they've got about – I think they had about 12 people sitting around, and it was a jam session. And it's open to the public, and they do it every week. But you can Google the music center – Blue Ridge Parkway Music Center. They've got a wonderful page. really great little museum there, but it is an awesome place to go for an afternoon if you're anywhere close to it. Now, a lot of the audience, you've got to have places you really like to take your family and you like to get away for a day, and we'd like to hear from you. What is a really great day trip that you remember that you'd like to recommend to others? I'd also like to encourage folks to Google Grayson Park in Mount Rogers. That's where the area that I went to, that's called Scales Trail. But if you'll Google that, it is a really neat place to take the family. Just the drive up to the front gate of the park is a neat drive. We appreciate you tuning in. And if you know anybody that might enjoy talking about a good day trip, let them know to tune in with you. We'll be back in a few minutes.
Let's go sunning, it's so good for you. Let's go sunning, neath the sky of blue. Greet the sun every morn. Feel as free and happy as the day you were born. Let's go native, sun your cares away. Be creative, learn to live and play. Pretty flowers need the sun.
Now, we're all proud of our hometowns, and you got a place near where you live that you'd like to let other people know about. This is a great opportunity to call in and share a day trip that would be good in your area. Our call-in number is 866-348-7884, 866-348-7884, and our topic are our favorite day trips. And Diane was talking about a wonderful place that we've got in our hometown called Old Salem.
Anyone that comes to visit me, of course, in Winston, we go to Old Salem. It is just so perfect to spend a day in Old Salem. Even in the summer when it's hot, it is still so well worth it. It is just beautiful.
Well, tell them about that. Is that a place where we send all the old people in town? Is that why we call it Old Salem?
You know, I don't know the whole Moravian. You probably know the whole Moravian story better than me. But I know that I just...
At one time, Winston-Salem were two different towns. And one town was Winston and one town was Salem. And Salem was set up by the Moravians. And the Moravians were some of the earliest founders in the country. And they came over with a special grant because they were persecuted in the Switzerland area of the old world. And they set up a really neat town that's been around for hundreds of years. The second oldest women's college in the United States is in Winston-Salem, in the center of Old Salem. What do you like about Old Salem?
I just love walking around, and I love the people dressed up in the costumes that work in Old Salem. I don't know what year that would be, Bill. Do you?
Well, they were well founded before 1776. So okay. Most of the costumes that they wear, and they've got it refurbished back to around that age of the country.
Well, it is just wonderful, and it's so fun to. They have like, what is it, like blacksmith shops that you can walk in. I used to take my son when he was little down there.
Now, have you been in the museum? They have an awesome three-story museum in there with all kinds of periodic material, as far as the 1770s. And then they also have an area for toys, really neat museum to spend some time in.
One interesting thing is I have known several friends. My son came back from Florida, was in a wedding. It's at that bridge. A lot of people are getting married. I think it's the bridge that goes to the museum. And it's very interesting. But, of course, liking to eat the sugar cake. You have to have sugar cake when you go to Old Salem. And then... Moravian chicken pie is fantastic.
Now, have you done the carriage rides? They've got horse carriage rides. And what are those two-wheel contraptions that you think you'll kill yourself on if you get on them? They've got a a tour group now where you can do a tour.
Oh, I know. What are they called?
Well, if somebody remembers what those two-wheel...
They had them in Raleigh when I lived in Raleigh, and I thought, first of all, there's no way I would get on one. I would definitely fall off before the motor even started. But yes, if you don't want... I can even walk Old Salem, so... But that is a nice way to do Old Salem.
Now, a place I love to go is called Linville Gorge. Linville Gorge is up around Blowing Rock. Grandfather's great during the week, but the parking just got awful up there. So I started going over and doing some hiking in Linville Gorge. Now, there's some places in Linville Gorge where you can park and roll a wheelchair down and look at just unbelievable views. On the other side, it's a whole lot more wilderness. There's a place called Table Rock, and there's a place called Hawkbill. And then one of the easiest walks down to the bottom of the gorge is called Spence Ridge. Now, Spence Ridge is about 2 miles long. It's all downhill to get to the river, which is wonderful. You just have to remember that that means it's all uphill coming back. But, I mean, it is just the most picturesque view down in the bottom. And then if you go in the other direction, you can go up to Table Rock. Now, it's a strenuous hike. It's a good hour, hour and a half. Would not go up there with a walker or a cane, but most folks that could do a tough hike can get to the top, and it just is breathtaking. Now, I've been up there with people with dogs, and I've been up there with kids that were 9 years old, so it's not that difficult. And then on the backside, if instead of going up from the parking lot at Table Rock, instead of heading toward Table Rock, you can go in the other direction. Now, a lot of people don't know about that trail. That trail's nowhere near as populated as the one going up to Table Rock, but it is one of the neatest, easiest hikes you'd ever do, and it's on top of the ridge. And I've got, every time I go, I think I'll walk about 2 minutes, and then I just start praying. I'm looking around on both sides in every direction. The views just take my breath, and I just can't help but to stand there and say, God, this is an awesome day. This is just a beautiful view. And I've got pictures for that hike on my Facebook page, and they're linked through the Christian Car Guy show. But that is a part of North Carolina that everybody needs to visit one side or the other. But if you're really looking for a great North Carolina hike, go up to Table Rock. And I've got to say that the road to it is a little challenging. I wouldn't take my new car to get down there, but I'd take an older car, and I'd certainly take a Jeep to get to it. You would want to print a map, because you get down, it's about a 7 mile dirt road before you get to the park at the top of the mountain. But Google Linville Gorge, and Google Spence Ridge, and Google Table Rock, and look at some of the pictures, and look at my Facebook page, and look at some of the sunrise pictures of those areas. And if you're anywhere close to the Boone area, the Blowing Rock area, plan on going over to Linville Gorge and at least going and seeing the falls part. The falls are a really nice side and an easy hike down. And the view down the backside is gorgeous. Call in and tell us about some of the places you like to take day trips and some place you think others should go to. Give us a call. We'll be right back. Talking off air about all kinds of neat things, and one thing was brought up to me that I haven't mentioned: Hanging Rock, and I haven't mentioned Pilot Mountain. If you're in the Piedmont, Pilot Mountain is an awesome place to go during the week. It's not a place I would go on the weekend. I have driven up there and had to turn around because it's packed. It's gorgeous. Now, it's a really great place to go at sunrise, which I've done a few times. But they've got a couple trails up there, And one trail, there's an awful lot of rock climbing and rappelling, and to be able to walk up that trail and watch all these different small groups do some rock climbing is a really, really neat way. And to take the kids with you and have the kids watch these teenagers and older folks jump off the mountain with a rope tied to them is a really neat way to spend some time. And then we've got a place called Hanging Rock. Now, Hanging Rock's got some beautiful trails. I like to go up there because you can do a circle. And there's about a 9-mile circle that you can do. But a lot of people go up and hike the Hanging Rock because that's the name of the park. But there's some other trails that are even more beautiful than Hanging Rock. One of them's called Moore's Knob, and there's a tower that you can go to the top of the tower. It's a rock tower, and the vistas from there are awesome, and you can see Pilot Mountain in the distance. But there, we've got some pictures that you can look at. Now, Charlotte's an interesting area if you want to go down there and enjoy their traffic. You were talking about some places folks should consider down in the Charlotte area.
Yes, I will tell you this, and this is a great co-host with Bill because he's hiking and I'm doing cities because I don't hike, again, my ankle excuse. But in Charlotte, my favorite place in Charlotte is called Noda area. It is an uptown Charlotte, and to me, it is sort of a little mini Asheville area. It's very eclectic and unique with different art galleries, ethnic restaurants. But my favorite place in that area to go is called the Noda Company Store.
Noda, spell that one for
us. It's capital N, small O, and then capital D-A.
At least it's easy to remember.
And that's the area.
Oh, that's the part of Charlotte.
That's the name of the store, too, the Noda.
Sort of sounds like what we used to say as teenagers, no duh.
Yeah, right.
Well, what is there fun to do there?
Well, at this company store, I don't know what it was before. It could have been an old store. But you can go in there and you can have meals, and it's local food. They host food trucks there during the week, but there's always food and drinks to order while you're there. But you can shop there, and it's anything from really nice linens to inexpensive T-shirts that are, again, unique and artsy. And my very favorite thing is they often host live music, and I love music. And a good friend of mine, who, oddly enough, I met after I moved to Charlotte, I mean to Asheville, is from Charlotte, and lives in Charlotte, and she was playing in Asheville at a festival, and I met her, and she was just amazing, and then she invited me to come to hear her perform at the Noda Company Store, and I will always go back two reasons, to hear her name is Christy Snow, and she is amazing, and she's also an ordained minister, and she has a church in Charlotte.
Now, you were talking about Rinalda House. Tell folks a little bit. You know, I lived here for a long time. I even rented an office space about a quarter mile from them and didn't go into Rinalda House until the last few years. Tell folks a little bit about Rinalda House.
The interesting thing about Rinalda House was I went there a few times early, and I gauged things by my son is 32. When he was probably 9 or 8, I would go to Rinalda House. They would have,
art exhibits?
No, art exhibits, but then lectures on that you would go to. And that was fascinating to go to sit there in the home, see the art, and then hear the expert explaining about the art. So I would do that a lot. Then I would take my husband and I would take our son, and we just camp out on the front lawn. We'd bring our dog and throw the frisbee and bring something to eat. It was always just great. Then when Ryan was probably around 12, Rinalda House, I'm not sure if they still do it, but they have a camp that you can go to, for children can sign up to go to. And there's a swimming pool there. In Rinalda House?
They get
house?
To use the pool at the Rinalda House?
Mm-hmm. If they go to the camp.
I wondered if anybody got to use that. This house, Winston-Salem is Winston-Salem because of the Reynolds. The Reynolds are the ones that got Wake Forest University set up in Winston-Salem, and an extension of the land that Wake Forest is set up on is Rinalda Village, and then Rinalda Village is connected to Rinalda House. So you had, at one time, you had Rinalda House, and then everything that was set up to take care of this really advanced, fancy farm that the Reynolds owned was down the hill, and they turned that into the village. Well, the house has been turned into an awesome museum, and it's just a really neat way to spend some time. But attached to the museum, they've got art exhibits that come through on a regular basis. So if you're going to visit anybody in the Winston area, you want to Google Rinalda House and see what's going on. We also would love for you to call in 866-348-7884. You've got to be proud of your area. There's got to be a really neat day trip you want folks in your area to know about. And we'd like you to share it at 866-348-7884.
I have one last thing to add about when Bill's talking about Rinalda House and Rinalda Gardens. Behind it are beautiful, and people hold weddings there. But you can start Rinalda House, walk through the gardens, down to the shopping areas, and then go straight through to Wake Forest. And it's fantastic.
Now, you know, Wake Forest has a museum of archaeology, I believe, that is really neat, that I've heard lots of great things about. And if you're in the area and you're looking for something to do, it'd be good to Google Wake Forest Museum. Let's see. We've got a caller. Let's see what we've got. Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Now I can hear you. I hope you're having a blessed morning.
I am. This is Roxanne here in Germantown, North Carolina.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you so much for calling in. What do you like to do in our area?
I'm telling you, you guys hit it on the spot. I've been to Asheville, and I love the antique stores over there.
Wonderful. Is there a particular store you'd like to mention?
Not in Asheville. I've been there twice. But in Hanging Rock, I've done the, for the past 2 years, I've done the Reach the Five Peaks.
Yes. That's a wonderful hike.
Oh, my goodness. Lots and lots. Last year, my son-in-law came from Florida, and he did it with me. So we did it together. He did the run. And I did the five peaks in 5 hours and 15 minutes.
That's a good trek. And beautiful. You get pictures when you go up?
Yes, I do, of course.
I've talked to lots of people that have gone to Hanging Rock, and when you talk to them about that rock tower, they look at you like you're crazy, like you just made that up. Have you tried to tell people about the hike from the campground up around Moore's Knob?
I've done that too, yes. My six grandchildren, I have eight grandchildren, but six of them came to visit for a summer, and I took them camping, and we stayed there at Hanging Rock Camp 5 days, and we did the hike. It took us about 3 hours, and I tell you, my kids loved it when we got up there. So if anything I can recommend is Hanging Rock. Either you want to go camping, you want to go swimming, you want to go fishing, you want to go hiking, and look at the mountains far away from Virginia. Oh, my Lord. Mm. So a beautiful place there, sir. Thank you for bringing this up. It was very good to hear you.
Yes, ma'am.
Roxanne, this is Diane. When was the last time you were in Asheville?
We have a couple of friends over there, and we went to this, I would say, maybe about a year and a half ago.
Okay, because you said you like antique stores, and there's so many around there, but there's a great one called Renovation Hardware Store that is fantastic.
Really?
Yes.
We went to that little downtown.
Yes.
You know, that little that's
Roxanne,
where we went.
Thank you so much for calling in. I hope you'll keep the station on your prayer list, and I hope you get back up to some of the other places we talked about to hike in the area.
I sure will. Thank you. Have a good day, sir.
Bye.
We look forward to some other callers calling in and sharing some of their favorite places to go.
Trip upon your magic swirling ship. My senses have been stripped. My hands can't feel to grip. My toes too numb to step. Wait only for my boot heels to be wandering.
Welcome back. We thank you for tuning in to the Christian Car Guy Show, and we're talking about day trips. And we were thinking about some of the ones that we've enjoyed the most. And I lived in Raleigh. I went to high school in Raleigh, but I never went to the museum, but I'd love to hear about it.
I lived in Raleigh, too, but that was from 2011 to 2013. And I did go to the art museum, the Raleigh Art Museum, and it is wonderful. The exhibits, and they have the visiting exhibits are fantastic. They have a great restaurant there to eat, but also one of the really interesting things about that museum is the trails all around the air, the museum. It's part of the museum. And there is sculpture on those trails. And you can bike, which I can bike, although I can't hike, I can ride a bike. So I would bike. You could bike for miles and walk those trails, and you still see art, too.
You know, in our area, in our state, there are lots and lots and lots of paved trails. In Winston-Salem, there, I bet we've got 50 miles of paved trail. There's a neat site you might want to consider called hikingproject.com, that if you go to hikingproject.com, you can use their map and you can find all kinds of different trails close to you, and it will give you a description of the trail, what you'll see, and it'll be rated by other people and there'll be pictures, but it's a really neat, neat site. Now, close to the museum in Raleigh, there's a fairgrounds. The state fairgrounds is there, and the flea market on Saturdays is well worth going to. It is absolutely huge. If you're looking for something fun to do close to Raleigh and you've got the time, go check out the state flea market. It is just a really neat adventure in itself.
I can add on to the state fairgrounds, because the state fair, I love fairs. I love the Dixie Classic Fair. I still ride every ride. And the North Carolina State Fair is fantastic.
You know, there are a lot of regional and local museums that people just don't think about. In Mount Airy, we've got an awesome museum. There was one little thing I wanted to go see in the museum, and I talked my wife into going up, and they've really fixed Mount Airy. Just, it's a neat place to go to drive around, and they've got some wonderful restaurants. But I talked her into going to the museum, and we were amazed. We were able to spend a good 2.5-3 hours going through that museum in Mount Airy. And there was all kinds of information on musicians. There was all kinds of things on Andy Griffith. There were all kinds of things on one of the world's largest granite mines is up there. At the history of it. And then the Siamese twins. I don't know if you've ever heard about the Siamese twins that were part of the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey. They retired in Mount Airy, and there's a fascinating section on that. There's a fascinating section on fire trucks and firemen. One of the worst fires in the nation evidently was in that area, and that's worth going. And then there's a little town called Hillsville up in the mountains. I don't know, that's a part of the Blue Ridge Parkway that I used to love taking my wife to. There really wasn't much you could do, and most of the meals were really reasonable. And there's a little restaurant there called the Hardware Store. And it's right across from the courthouse. So we saw the sign museum, and we went over. And in the basement of the courthouse, there is just a really nice-sized, small museum that was well worth the money. So what I'm saying to you is Google your area, your counties next to you, and see if there's some small museums that you haven't gotten around to, and go check them out and tell people about going and seeing, because there are a lot of folks that just get stuck at home watching the TV. And, yeah, I tell people when I go in the jail and I talk to the inmates, I say, you know, it's fine to watch that show for the first time. It's great to watch the news. There's nothing wrong with the sports. But when you're watching a show, when you know what they're going to say before they say it, maybe you're not being the best steward of your time. Get out and go do something.
And I want to add to that when we're talking about museums, again, take your children. The museum Bill's talking about in Mountain Airy, what a wonderful day trip for you and your family and take your kids. They'll love it. It's perfect.
You've been to Moorhead City. You've been to Beaufort.
Yes. Oh, my gosh. That's so beautiful there.
Moorhead City is, I do scuba diving, and one of the best scuba diving places on the entire East Coast is Olympus out of Moorhead City. But across the water from them on the other side is Beaufort.
Mm-hmm.
And Beaufort's got a museum there on the Marine, the beginning of the Coast Guard. And it started from all along the coast. They used to have these little clubs, and they had some boats ready. And if there was a shipwreck, then everybody would come, and they'd go out and they'd rescue people. Now, they don't really add too much about that. Part of the reason you did that is afterwards you got to keep all the stuff that washed up on the shore. But they had these groups that set up these rescue, and I mean, unbelievable what they would do to help rescue the people off the boat. But that Maritime Museum in Beaufort is well worth the drive to go down and see all that they've got just on the topic of how that evolved into the Coast Guard. We've got a lot of neat things on the North Carolina Outer Banks.
I love the Outer Banks. That's where I grew up. My mother grew up in Southampton County, Virginia, and that's where we spent our vacation in the summer, 2 weeks in the Outer Banks, and it was fantastic. That is my, I have to say, love North Carolina, never want to live in any other state, but the Outer Banks is just amazing.
Have you done the Kitty Hawk?
Of course, I've done everything.
Now, one of the things I remember clearest in my mind, one of the neatest trips I ever took was we went to Kitty Hawk. And we just accidentally stumbled across the narration that they've got a park specialist that there that does a narration of all about the first flight.
Mm-hmm.
And it's been taped. I'm sure there's ways to see it. But it is one of the neatest things. I would have paid real money to have gone and seen him produce that on a stage somewhere. But to see him do it there in front of the plane that was used for the first control flight. One of the neatest vacations I ever did was going up and doing Kitty Hawk. Now, we've got Paula. Let's see if I can push the right button here. Paula, can you hear me? There we go. Paula, are you there? I lost Paula. Okay. There's some museums, some aquariums all along the North Carolina coast. I know there's one in Wilmington that we really, really love. I don't remember. There's one on the Outer Banks, too, isn't there?
There is, but I can't think about that. But speaking about the Outer Banks, now I'm coming up at a loss. The play. Where
oh,
everyone,
the,
what is it?
I want to say Roanoke, but...
Yeah, but it's about that.
It's about the first settlers.
Right,
that
I have seen that so many times, and that is so wonderful.
Well...
And that's a Manio, right, adjacent.
There we go, yes. We appreciate you tuning in. I hope you've heard about or thought about going to some places that you hadn't thought about before. We'd love for you to go to the Christian Gar Guy page on Facebook and like us and friend us. And we'd love for you to go to thechristiancarguy.com. We appreciate you tuning in. And I hope you have a wonderful week. Thank you.
Thank you, Bill, for letting me join you.